everything in place?
The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us. You can see it when you look out your window or when you turn on your television. You can feel it when you go to work, when you go to church, when you pay your taxes. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
That you are a slave.
What's your problem?
Yo, I'm a paparazzi. I don't play no Yahtzee. I go pop, 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 pop. My camera's up your crotch.
If you want to be a drag queen and your parents don't let you, you need new parents.
I asked Netflix if I could do a holiday special for the first episode of season 2. And being the super cool company they are, they said, sure, why not? Sort of. I mean, they asked why. So when I was a kid, I loved holiday specials in the shows that I watched. There was this intersection of my life with the lives of these characters, like Hill Street Blues and Mork and Mindy and All My Children, that I can still remember the holiday specials even better than I can remember the shows. There's something about birthdays and holiday celebrations. We notice things about each other. We see how tall kids have grown. We notice how much our hair has gone gray. Hashtag go pink.
But I've also been really lucky to work with filmmakers like Ryan Coogler that say, yo, help me. Like, I want my female character to feel like a real woman, not an imitation of one. Feel like a real woman, not an imitation of one.
You are the best kept secret in the universe.
I am Adora, He-Man's twin sister and defender of the Crystal Castle. This is Spirit, my beloved steed. Fabulous secrets were revealed to me the day I held aloft my sword and said, for the honor of Grayskull! A few others share this secret.
Being president is a serious job.
Good evening, godless sodomites.
We're here to talk about the end of the world.
And anybody who believes that I am man obviously is an idiot.
She's a man.
He's lying.
If you want to be a drag queen and your friends don't let you, you need new friends. Super pumped. I'm gonna walk the runway and I'm gonna Vogue.
Virgin Voguing, because he's been taking Voguing classes. Okay. With Gerard X. Reyes, who's fantastic. He's doing first time in drags at a ball.
For this cause, God gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was meat. And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind, to do those things which are not convenient.
You see, I take these glasses off, she looks like a regular person, doesn't she, huh? Put them back on, formaldehyde face.
Old man river, that old man river.
You know, you look like your head fell on the cheese dip back in 1957.
We are all shapeshifters. We are all lonely drifters. We've forgotten us when we escaped through the winking eyes and the secret handshakes. Disposable me, expendable you. Just take what you need and do what you do. This heart has seen better days. You got my number. Girl, there's no change in my ways. Over and over, you're on your own. Shapeshifters, 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 shapeshifters. I'm running from me, I'm hiding from you. There goes my alter ego. You know everyone that I know. Abandon the street, abandon the truth. There goes my alter ego. You know all the people I know.
Over a year since I made my video exposing Charlotte Flair as being a man. Very obvious, very clear for those that have eyes to see. This is a screenshot from my previous video. As you can see here, Ric Flair kissing his son. Give me a break. Show this short clip, which I showed before, again in my previous video. You can clearly see this is a man. The body of a man, there's absolutely no hips whatsoever. The back, I mean, completely obvious. Let's take a look at some of these photos. As I shown before, completely, completely masculine, because of course it is a man. I mean, give me a break again. Now, again, some of the photos I showed before, getting to the photos that were supposedly stolen from Charlotte Flair. As I shown before, absolutely no hips. How is this thing supposed to give birth? These are not the hips of a so-called female. Actually, the abs go out further than the hips themselves. Okay, clearly a man. Just for reference, this photo I showed before as well. These are the hips of a female where you have the indentation. Clear as day, the huge difference. Okay, from male to female. Now, these photos, I warn you, they're a little bit too much, but they need to be shown for reference. These are the so-called photos that were stolen and released on the internet of Charlotte Flair, completely exposing him as a man. I mean, take a look at this body. You really believe this is a female? No way. Okay, a little bit of a closer look here. Sorry for these photos, but they need to be shown for reference. One thing, I always talk about how the devil is in the detail. Take a look at this arm. What do you see? Look at all that hair. Okay, this is of course, the arm of a male. You see the vein itself. But this is definitely an arm of a man. You know, he forgot to shave this day before taking these photos. And the back of a man, clearly the arms. This is no female. These are a little bit disturbing. These photos, I, of course, had to censor them for this video. But you can see, again, clearly no hips whatsoever, the abs of a man. I can't show the breast, of course, but they did a really bad job. Basically a botched job, just like in wrestling. But these boobs have been botched as well. One is clearly much larger than the other. Okay, completely disgusting, but it needs to be shown for reference. Clearly the abs of a man, the indentation, that belly button, the position of the belly button itself. And again, comparing to a female, a real female, it's night and day. Okay, it's not even questionable. Okay, let's take a look here. Again, just for reference. Clearly, this is a man. Okay, without question. Now, cover this. Now, I want to get into more details about this whole concept of the transgender angle. With Charlotte Flair, it is absolutely nothing new. They've been doing this forever. Okay. With the so-called Williams sisters, nothing more than the Williams brother, just two dudes with makeup and hair beads. Okay. Going back in time, as a former mocker, they were spotlighted on Trans World Sport. Of course, dual meaning with trans being across the world and also transgender. This is how the elite love a play on names and why they are spotlighted on Trans World Sport. As you see here with the father who adopted these two young boys and basically made them into tennis players. Take a look here at Venus. I've shown this many times before. The hands of a man, the feet of the man, the legs of a man. Just a crotch chop and a dude with a wig. That's all you have here. Okay, more photos of these two dudes when they were younger. The hands of a man. Look at these faces. I mean, you take away this tie, this ribbon, whatever you call it, in the hair, and this rubber band, and you have two young males trying to pass themselves off as females, of course. And the world, for the most part, has bought it. They bought into this lie. They've been groomed, these two boys, to be future tennis stars as so-called females. See them here, basically, the early stages, again, being groomed by the so-called elite with Ronald and Nancy Reagan. And you see the two Wilson rackets, you get your, just like WWE, the WWE logo, there's no E in the logo, it's just two W's. You turn those W's sideways, you get your 33 once you turn those WW sideways. Again, that's why there's no E in the logo. It's all about Freemasonry, as I show many times. It's basically the 33, order out of chaos. And I find it interesting when you have, for example, Seth Rollins as WWE champion. When he has the belt on his shoulder, you can clearly see the 33 position perfectly. And also, one thing I want to mention as well, talking about the Williams brothers being groomed.
So this is kind of a continuation of part one, where I talked about Inanna, the mother goddess, queen of heaven, goes by many different names. The priesthood associated with this goddess is a transvestite, and we've seen that from ancient Babylon. Then it gets into Greece and Rome. So this mother goddess is worshipped all over the world. Today goes by different names. And the system of eunuch priests, or transvestite priests, has also spread around the world. So I came across this academic journal called Priests of the Goddess, Gender Transgression in Ancient Religion by Will Roscoe, 1996. So this paper talks about mainly three types of transvestite priests of the mother goddess. The first are the Galli from Greece. Undoubtedly, the most shocking practice attributed to Galli self-castration. And next are the Hydra, neither man nor woman. The Hydra of India, members of a contemporary cult of goddess worshippers, estimated to number some 50,000 in northern India alone, with roots that may be as old or older than those of the Galli. Hydra are males devoted to the worship and service of Bahukara Mata, one of the many Indian mother goddess figures. The most striking parallel between the two cults is the practice of castration. In both cases, the procedure appears to have been traditionally performed in a temple, with the parts buried there or under a tree. In the case of Hydra, both penis and testicles are removed by an expert, while the initiate chants the name of the mother goddess. The blood is allowed to flow freely in the belief that it drains away the heat that is the source of both maleness and sexual desire. As a result, the initiate is nirvana, liberated, reborn. He becomes a sannyasi or itinerant saint who embodies the strength of the goddess. Embodies the strength, all right? He's possessed by the goddess and is able to convey it to others in the form of blessings and also curses. They channel the goddess of fertility. Castration does not transform Hydra into women. We are neither men nor women, although they generally wear women's clothing in public. Their exaggerated femininity and body public behavior immediately gives them away as Hydra. It's kind of like the Hydra celebrities that we see on TV. Their body public behavior gives them away. Some Hydra fulfilled important roles in palace administration, kind of like in the White House. They still do. The oldest texts attribute supernatural powers and or religious roles to eunuchs. Now we'll look at ancient Mesopotamia. The oldest of these roles is that of the Sumerian Gala priest. See, Gala became Gali in Greece. Gala appear in temple records dating back to the middle of the 3rd millennium BC. The word Gala was written using the signs penis plus anus. All right. So Kalu, Kugaru, and Asinu were typically identified as servants of Inanna Ishtar. They appear to have portrayed the goddess in ritual by wearing masks and cross-dressing. Now there's the story, The Descent of Inanna. Inanna went down to the netherworld. All reproduction stopped when Inanna was in the underworld. The way that Inanna came back from the netherworld was that Enki created androgynes to help Inanna come back to the world. So it was the androgynes that could transcend the barriers between the material and the spiritual world. The androgynes were like a portal to another world. In the Era myth, for example, Ishtar is referred to as changing the masculinity of the Kugaru and Isinu into femininity. Although this has been interpreted as evidence of a physical transformation, namely castration, it could just as easily refer to a psychological transformation, the result of divine possession or visitation, as was the case with the Galli and Hydra. So they're being possessed by the goddess. Table 1. Parallels among Mediterranean, the Greeks and the Romans, Indian, and Mesopotamian goddess priesthoods. Membership by initiation. They practice spontaneous self-castration and castration in a temple, with parts buried there. Attis, their mythological patron, castrates himself under a pine tree. Ah, like a Christmas tree? While the Hydra in India, again, membership by initiation, parts buried there under a tree. Self-castration occurs in myths. Let's check out the Gala, Kugaru, and the Asinu from Babylon and Assyria. Ceremonies for the new Gala. All right, in Babylon, gender transformed by Inanna Ishtar, partly female and partly Galli specific dress. Hydra the cross dress, combination of male and female dress. They'll wear male on one side and female clothes on the other side. Gala sing in female dialect, so they sing like women. Kugaru and Asinu wear goddess masks, channeling the goddess. Sagarsag dress half male, half female. Same thing. Priests of Sibyl, religious performers, festivals, MTV Video Awards, the Oscars, music, singing, dancing, bloodletting, acting as well, theater. All right, now this is from a book called The Syrian Goddess by Lucian in the middle of the 2nd century BC. The goddess was Rhea, the shrine work of Attis, first taught the sacred mysteries of Rhea. For when Rhea deprived him of his powers, he put off his manly garb and assumed the appearance of a woman and her dress. And roaming over the whole earth, he performed his mysterious rites, narrating his sufferings and chanting the praises of Rhea. He also affirmed that the Galli, who are in the temple, in no case castrate themselves in honor of Juno, but of Rhea. And this is imitation of Attis. Meantime, the custom once adopted remains even today. And many persons every year castrate themselves and lose their virile powers. They certainly castrate themselves and then cease to wear man's garb. They don women's raiment and perform women's tasks. During these days, there are made Galli. As the Galli sing and celebrate their orgies, frenzy falls on many of them, and many who had come as mere spectators afterwards are found to have committed the great act. The great act, the great work, the philosopher's stone. I used to be a little boy. It burns. Any young man who has resolved on this action strips off his clothes and with a loud shout bursts into the midst of the crowd and picks up a sword from a number of swords which I suppose have been kept ready for many years for this purpose. He takes it and castrates himself and then runs wild through the city, bearing in his hands what he has cut off. He casts it into any house at will, and from this house he receives women's raiment and ornaments. Maybe some makeup as well. Then he goes to Hollywood. Thus they act during their ceremonies of castration.
Trans world sport, that's all it is. You see here as well, female, so-called female tennis player, Samantha Stauser. Just take a look here. Okay, I mean, some might say, oh, this is questionable if this is a male or female. It looks like a female to me. That's what some will say. But take a look at these photos. It's going to be clear as day. You can clearly see those male arms, the wrist, the whole entire body, the legs. Get a little bit of a close-up. Remove the head, and you can clearly see this is the anatomy of a male. You can see actually the sides here, kind of bulging out a little bit as a male, of course. Just take a look at these legs. Take a look at those arms. It's a complete joke. I mean, obvious for those that have eyes to see. People might say, well, if this is true, why doesn't the media say anything? If what you're saying is true, of course, the media is controlled by the same people that control sports, that control Hollywood, they control the music industry, they control the politicians, they control it all. So they're not going to give you this truth, of course. Now take a look here as well at these photos of Samantha Stauser. You can clearly see, again, the body of a man, of course, wearing the orange as well. Basically coated with Freemasonry, the only color in numerology that is 33 being orange. Okay, this is why you'll see him wearing orange a lot. Just like a lot of these so-called celebrities, they love the color orange for that number 33 hidden in plain sight. Just take a look here at these arms, these hands. It's a complete joke. The posture of a male. One thing I found interesting too with this one photo, with him wearing a dress. Take a close look. Again, the devil is in the details. Take a look at the hairline. Okay, this is a receding hairline of a male. It's clear as day. Now, and there are occultists behind this all. They, of course, are allowing this to take place. Just take a look at this one photo. Again, wearing the orange in the coded 666. The sixes are reversed, hidden in plain sight. You get your backward six, six, and six. Okay, just like I'm going to show an example here with so-called South African runner, Castrit Semenye, showing the hands. Okay, I'm going to get into the occultic side with him as well. Clearly a man, this is a complete insult. Again, the media is not going to give you this truth. You take a look at these females in the back, and he comes in to first place to take the victory. Semenye, also a play of names with you know what in the name. Okay, it's all about Baphomet. Okay, take a look here. Basically, it's a mockery of God's creation of male and female being separate. They integrate both male and female in one. You see the male arms and the female breast. Okay, of course, the goat's head as well. This is the Masonic goat god, again, Baphomet. Take a look at the two fingers, sign of benediction, and you'll see Castrit Semenye do the same. Same exact thing. Of course, instructed to, told to do this. Okay, it's all in plain sight for those that understand the occult. Okay, just more photos. Take a look at the number 33 once again. Always coded, not by chance, not by coincidence. Now take a look at this photo with a female next to Castor Semenye. I mean, this trying to pass him off as a female, it's a complete insult, complete joke. If you have a brain in your head, you can clearly see this is a man without question. Just more the same. Again, the number 33 in that man's face, that man's body. Just had a crotch chop job done. It all comes down to. Take a look here as well. Next to a male. This is supposed to be the female. This is the male. Give me a break. This guy's laughing. He knows. He knows this is a dude. 100%. Now in the WNBA. I've covered this before as well with Brittany Griner. Clearly a male. Absolutely no indentation in the hips. Complete insult. Why would a female wear this cut-up shirt like this, basically exposing her so-called breast? And you see, again, the occultic side of the dual devil horns. And what does this remind you of? This photo of so-called Michelle Obama, more or less Michael Obama, again, with the hidden devil horns. I mentioned before as well, take a look at these photos with Michael Obama. Clear as day that this is a male. One thing I want to mention too, with this photo, clearly, I mean, even though he is wearing heels, take away the heels, he's still going to be taller than this guy and Angela Merkel. And, of course, the diamond sign, which I mentioned before, is the hidden code for the number 33 in plain sight. This is why you see her obsessed with doing the diamond sign. And this is the concept of Freemasonry, which is duality and deception, like I showed earlier with Angela Merkel. And you see, again, Michelle Obama or Michael Obama. Take a look at this one photo again. Let me get back on the whole topic of the transgender angle that they push. Again, the world of opposites, where you see Michelle Obama or Michael Obama looking like Big Bird in this photo. Give me a break. Now, this whole concept is nothing new. Getting back to the beginning of the video and showing Charlotte Flair once again, this whole concept. Okay, this is nothing new once again. Take a look here as you see the so-called royal family of Monaco. And you see Stephanie, so-called Princess Stephanie. You know, from this photo, you know, he does look like a female. But again, the devil is in the details. Taking a closer look. And again, the 99%, they don't look at the details. They just believe, oh, the news is going to tell us the truth. Why would they lie to us? They don't understand it. Once again, who controls the media? You know, people on TV, they're just script readers. They're reading off a teleprompter. Just take a look at these photos of so-called Princess Stephanie. Clearly a man. Born a male. Clear as day. So just an example, again, how with Charlotte Flair, this is nothing new. This has been going on for a very, very long time. So-called elite. Again, the world of opposites, the world of duality. Let's take a look at this shot with the bikini. Clearly a male's body, just like Charlotte Flair. No difference whatsoever. It's basically what they're doing is the same tricks over and over again on the masses, and they cannot see with their own eyes. They rely on the so-called media to give them the truth. They don't understand. They're basically furthest from the truth as possible. Basically kept dumbed down. Here's a photo. Older. You can see the size of the hand, the body. They try to pass off this man as a woman. You know, and again, the Masonic hand sign, keeping secrets. The sign of confidentiality with Stephanie, of course, a male. This is 100% mockery. Now, photos of an older so-called Princess Stephanie. Clearly a male. Just take a look at that body. These people are sick and twisted. Now, this one photo as well, holding a young boy, clearly a man. Those hands, look at the body, no hips whatsoever. Now, this is going to be a little bit much for some. I covered this before with the whole idea, again, with Charlotte Flair being turned into a female. The same exact thing with Ivanka Trump, more like Ivan Trump. Here, take a look at this photo. of a young so-called Ivanka. This is clearly a young boy with long hair. Just take away the hair, and you have a little boy. So it's what Trump is doing with so-called Ivanka and the royal family, again, with Princess Stephanie. People need to be able to connect all the pieces, connect all the dots, and see the obvious. Okay? New information like this, for those who are new to it, of course it's going to be rejected in the outset. But give it time to sink in. You know, use your own eyes. Use your own mind. Don't be a drone and just go by what everybody else thinks. It's clear as day. Okay, take a look here. As I showed this photo before with Donald Trump, with his son, and just take a look at the size of that hand. Okay, this is Trump's hand here, and this is Ivanka, so-called Ivanka, more like Ivan. Okay, closer look. And to be perfectly clear here, some people have this confused in previous videos that I put out. They say, no, this is Trump's hand. No, this is Trump's hand in the back. You see the collar, you see the thumb extended, and this is clearly so-called Ivanka's hand. Look at the size. Give me a break. Okay, supposedly Ivanka pregnant. This is less than 48 hours, supposedly, after giving birth. Again, look at the size of that hand. No way. Okay, and here's a supposed photo a week after, supposedly giving birth. Absolutely no way this man gave birth. Take a look here. Obvious. Now, what they want to get into as well, with this one transgender, this is not even debatable. His name is Jenna Talichkova. Okay, if the media said this was a female, born a female, then 99.9% would buy it without question. Okay? I found it very interesting. Getting back to Donald Trump, he actually supported her. You know, with his organization that he owns, that he states, Donald Trump says transgender model can compete. Again, Jenna Talichkova can compete in Miss Universe. Okay? So again, Trump, of course, he's going to okay it, knowing his son, of course, being a transgender as well. Take a look here. Another photo of this transgender. Again, if the media said if this was a female, born a female, the masses would buy it. It's more of the same here with Jenna. Basically, when it comes down to, Jenna looks more like a female than Ivanka. Look at those shoulders. Look at the arms. Look at the stomach. This is clearly a dude. The hair just looks like a wig on a dude. That's what it all comes down to.
The female deity is shown by her very name, Atargatis, to be a form of Ishtar or Astarte. A custom of similar character commonly attached itself to the worship of the Great Mother in her various forms. So the religion of Sibyl entered the Roman world. When Imperial Rome conquered the larger part of the Mediterranean world, the religion of Sibyl followed in its wake. Neither is he changed into a woman, nor does he remain a man, wrote Augustine. All right, this is from Augustine's City of God, written around the 4th century. To be present in the temples of devils, to witness the priests of Sibyl mutilating themselves, the effeminate being consecrated, castrated, the raving fanatics cutting themselves, Galli, the castrated priests of Sibyl. These gods of the pagans are all evil, because they are not gods, but evil spirits. These gods who desire to be honored by theatrical plays, these gods exacting plays in their own honor, they had them dedicated to themselves, consecrated to themselves, the demons who delighted in blinding men to the truth. The gods demand stage plays in their own honor. So there's this correlation between the transvestite priest and the actors in the dramas. And the Olympics, by the way, right? The Olympics is also done in honor of the gods. That's why we have all these transgendered Olympic athletes. The golden ass, all right, there's another primary source. Everyone hideously made up, their faces crazy with muddy paints, and their eyes artfully lined. The soil became wet with the filthy blood of the effeminates. Carl Jung sees the figure of the androgyne, the projection of a longing for a return to primordial unity. Sounds like the United Nations, for escape from the unbearable tension of the opposites. That's why they have all this Me Too movement and all these sexual harassment things in the news. They're all fake to give us the unbearable tension of the opposites to give us chaos, and they will bring order, which is primordial unity, for a mode of humanity no longer divided into halves. Plato Symposium. Transcending gender had to begin with the renunciation of sexuality. At the time of the birth of Christ, cults of men devoted to a goddess flourished throughout the broad region, extending from the Mediterranean to South Asia. While Gali were missionizing the Roman Empire, Kalu, Kurgaru, and Asinu continued to carry out ancient rites in the temples of Mesopotamia. And the third gender predecessors of the Hydra were clearly evident in India. All right, this is 2,000 years ago. There were trannies all over the place. To complete the picture, we should also mention the Megabazoi, or eunuch priests of Artemis at Ephesus. All right, now that's what where Paul goes there. Western Semitic Kedashim, the male temple prostitutes, known from the Hebrew. All right, that's the in the Bible. They call them Kedashim. That's plural for Kadesh. All right, a sodomite is a transvestite priest for the mother goddess. The real translation should be transvestite pagan priest. There are some Bible verses talking about sodomites. So the King James, there shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel, nor sodomite of the sons of Israel. All right, so this word sodomite. And this is the English Standard Version. None of the daughters of Israel shall be a cult prostitute, and none of the sons of Israel shall be a cult prostitute. All right, so the word sodomite is now called cult prostitute. We don't realize that these are transvestite priests for the pagan gods. Now, this is the Septuagint, which is actually the oldest copy of the Bible we have. There shall not be an initiated person of the sons of Israel. You see that? Initiated. There's an initiation. They're being castrated to the gods. All right. Now, 1 Kings 14:24, again, King James. There were sodomites in the land, and they did according to all the abominations of the nations. There were transvestite priests in the land. All right, that's what that means. English Standard Version. There were also male cult prostitutes in the land. Now, Septuagint, again. And there was a conspiracy in the land. Not a conspiracy theory. There was an actual conspiracy. A secret plan by a group to do something unlawful or harmful. That's what it means. There was a conspiracy of trannies in the land, and they did according to all the abominations of the nations, all right? So that's what the Septuagint said. The oldest version of the Bible we have calls it a conspiracy. And the Septuagint also says they were initiated, an initiated person through the mystery schools, the pagan religions. All right, now finally somebody removed the sodomites out of the land and abolished the practices which his fathers had kept up. All right, the Israelites started doing this stuff. And from the land he exterminated the remnant of the male cult prostitutes. And he pulled down the house of the sodomites that were by the house of the Lord, where the women wove tents for the grove. All right, and King Josias burnt those who had in them a divining spirit, the wizards, the images, the idols, and the sodomites, which were in the land of Judah and Jerusalem. So the transvestite priests, they're in the same category as divining spirit, wizards, images, idols, transvestite priests. And then actually in Job, the word Kadesh in Hebrew is used here. They die in their youth and their life is among the unclean. It's pretty vague, right? You don't know what that means. They die in their youth and their life ends among the cult prostitutes, all right? The Hebrew word is Kadesh, transvestite priests. Now look at this, Septuagint. Let their soul die in youth and their life be wounded by messengers of death. So the tranny priest is a messenger of death, according to the Septuagint. Leviticus 18, this whole chapter is basically about sexual sin and sexual boundaries and stuff like that. Then right in the middle of it, he says, shall not give any of your children to offer them to Molech, and so profane the name of your God. Sexual sin, don't do this, don't sleep with your mother, that kind of stuff. And then all of a sudden, don't sacrifice your children to Molech? Murdering children in a chapter about sexual sin. No, I believe this is talking about castrating children to Molech. Do not castrate your child to Molech. That's the ritual. That's the initiation. And then it talks about homosexuality, and then it talks about bestiality. But he walked in the way of the kings of Israel, and made his son to pass through the fire, according to the abominations of the heathen. sons pass through the fire, that's an initiation. I believe that's a castration ritual they're talking about. They're passing through the fire. See, they're not thrown in the fire. They're passing through it. They come out the other side of the fire, but they're changed. He said, don't turn your child into sodomites. He says it right here. And here it says, they burnt their sons and daughters in the fire, which I commanded them not to. This is from the Jewish Virtual Library, from the Cult of Moloch. They speak about passing children to Moloch in the fire. According to rabbinic interpretation, this prohibition is against passing children through fire and then delivering them to the pagan priests, right? Passing them through fire, then delivering them to pagan priests.
Okay, now, let us talk about this abomination. This is the pagan Canaanite idol god Moloch. Now, it is part of an exhibition and it has been displayed at the entrance of the Colosseum in Rome. Now, this exhibition is expected to run until March 29, 2020. Now, this ancient god Moloch requires child blood sacrifice. Right, it requires the blood of our children. And if you go to the Bible in Leviticus 18:21, it gives an account of this. Now also, it is alleged that the approval came from the Vatican for this Canaanite idol to be put on display in Rome. Now we are getting somewhere. The Vatican allegedly approve a god that requires a child sacrifice. Let that sink in. Now we see where we are going. These people are grooming you to accept, right? To accept these ancient god and these ancient practices. They are trying to bring back the old ways.
The Matrix is a computer-generated dream world built to keep us under control in order to change a human being into this.
Drag Queen Story Hour.
This one is called Worm Loves Worm.
Talking, singing, and reading.
We can both be grooms.
To an audience of preschoolers, toddlers, and their caregivers.
The hips on the drag queen go swish, swish, swish. Swish, swish, swish. Swish, swish, swish. I'm a girl.
Stop. Let me out. Let me out. I want
to look at them. They're everywhere.
Now, hold on. You ain't the first son of a bitch to wake up out of their dream.
The day my water broke, I was recording Jessica Rabbit.
No. I don't believe it. It's not possible.
Don't you need? You need a Brazilian plastic surgeon.
I've got one that can see.
Were you listening to me, Neo? Or were you looking at the woman in the red dress?
I was...
Look again.
It took me 20 years to find you. How many people can say that? You are the best kept secret in the universe. And I found you.
Which makes me perfect for this job.
You really think a black suit is going to solve all your problems?
No, but looks damn good on you.
We are a rumor. Recognizable only as deja vu and dismissed just as quickly. Time to prove yourself, Agent M. We may have a problem in London.
Welcome to MIB. You will be with Agent H.
Recognizable only as deja vu and dismissed just as quickly. You don't exist. You were never even born. Anonymity is your name. Silence your native tongue.
You know what the difference is between you and me?
I make this look good.
But I've also been really lucky to work with filmmakers like Ryan Coogler that say, yo, help me. Like, I want my female character to feel like a real woman, not an imitation of one. Feel like a real woman, not an imitation of one.
You are the best kept secret in the universe.
He and Lord and push for gender neutral language. Theologically, for instance, we know that God is beyond our gender determinations. God is not a man. First female bishop says calling God he is a growing problem. Oh, it's a growing problem. I think it's always been there. It's always been normal, but now all of a sudden it's a growing problem. God should not be referred to as he. Ah, Bishop Rachel Treweek has said the Church of England should not call God he. Well, what should we call you, Bishop? Church of Sweden to start using gender-neutral terms for God. And look at this. They got the sun imagery, the sun god imagery. All right, so they're using Christian names in these churches, but they're just masking their underlying gods and goddesses. And it's all about the androgynous god. They've turned Mother Mary into a goddess. You got Osiris, Isis, and Horus is the androgyne baby. Episcopal Church considers a gender-neutral god our work toward equity. The entire Episcopal Church is now actively considering replacing all masculine pronouns referring to God, such as Father and Him, with gender-neutral terms. The Episcopal News Service said that church leaders felt the masculine pronouns created a barrier to evangelizing young people. To brainwashing young people. That's what you mean. Throughout Scripture, God continually refers to Himself as Father and presents Himself to humanity as masculine. Christ, who is also both man and God, called God the Father, and ascended into heaven in a male body. That is true. For Catholics, the feminine aspects of the Church have always been represented in the Virgin Mary, whom they believe was crowned Queen of Heaven and by the Church itself. Yeah, Queen of Heaven. They turn Virgin Mary into a goddess. They pray to the goddess. They worship the goddess. That's not biblical, all right? Is God gender neutral? Episcopal Church debates altering language in Book of Common Prayer to make it clear God is not male. They're going to make it clear. How is Sweden making the church gender neutral? Changing the words, the pronouns? U.S. Episcopal Church mulls radical plan to make God gender neutral. May follow Church of Sweden in removing spiritually exclusive terms like Holy Father. And the Church of England tells schools to let children explore gender identity. Pupils need to be able to play with the many cloaks of identity to explore the possibility of who they might be. All right. Well, we're straight out of the Kabbalah, straight out of the Talmud, straight out of Freemasonry, ancient Babylonian mysticism. So here, this is from Teen Vogue. Teen Vogue magazine, all right? This is aimed at teenagers. Who reads Teen Vogue? Teenagers. Those are the only people who read Teen Vogue. All your questions about gender-neutral pronouns answered. From grammar to what to do if you mess it up. Well, they're making it illegal to use the proper pronouns now. All right, this is fascism. This is trans fascism. When I tell someone that my preferred pronouns are they, them, their, I never know what to expect. And basically what they're doing now in schools is that you have to inform people what your preferred pronoun is. You can choose your own pronouns now in schools. And then if somebody doesn't know what your pronoun is, they're like guilty of assault or something. Why use they instead of he, she? Well, I'll tell you why. Let's look at Genesis verse 27. Male and female created he them. Them is plural, meaning more than one person. So you can have one male and one female created them. Now, if they change the meaning of this word to be talking about one person, then you have male and female, he created that one person. They're saying God created that one person, both male and female. They are changing the definition of this word from more than one person. They're changing it to talk about only one person. And they're changing the image of God when they do that. because of this person was one person, both male and female, then God was also both male and female. That's what they're doing, all right? And in doing so, they are actually recreating human beings. This is their plan, and this is going to result in the Great Tribulation when people refuse to go along with it. Now, right now, most people don't even know this is happening. This is happening. So they're basically rewriting Genesis 1 so that we all end up worshiping this person and all end up looking like this person. A lot of people already look like this person. For example, right? I mean, that's a movie, okay? That's your androgynous God right there, okay? A lot of people already look like the Baphomet. The male jaw you got there, male cheekbones, male eye sockets. But you got the red lipstick. Oh, well, I guess you're a woman, huh?
It's 2018. There's going to be drag kids in the world. And I'm one of them. I got into drag when I watched the first episode of RuPaul's Drag Race. I stopped playing with my toys because my mom was watching it. I liked how they looked so fabulous, and I wanted to be like that. So I would take my mom's towels, bed sheets, etc., and her heels, and put them on, and then walk down the hallway, etc. I would try to look like Courtney, but it would turn out to look like a disastrous monster. Monstrosity. After I went viral and my 15 years of fame came, my mom's friend decided to make a Facebook page called Desmond is Amazing, and I liked the name so much that it's I'd say to keep it as my drag name, and it stuck. My mom is my dragager. We always bring on our drags because we're the dream team. Express yourself however you want, and there's no boundaries to what you do. Because if you have to deal with negative things, it'll be more easier to deal with them. But if you're not expressing yourself, in my point of view, it's going to be hard to deal with it. Amazing that there's so many other drag kids out there expressing themselves. Just like my motto is, be yourself always, no matter what anyone says, and pay the haters no mind, because they'll never be as fierce as you and I. Anyone can do drag, even a dog. Woof woof.
In other words, according to this interpretation, this refers to an initiation rite. Initiation or consecration. Remember that? We've seen these words already used in terms of sodomites. An initiated person. It's another word for a castrated priest to the mother goddess. So the word sodomite, not an inhabitant of Sodom, but those devoted, kedeshim, plural of kadesh, those devoted to unnatural lust in Ashtoreth's honor. Ashtoreth, Her priests were eunuchs in women's attire, prostituting themselves to enrich the temple of this goddess. Effeminatus, right? Sodomite, Kadesh, Effeminatus in Latin. This dreadful consecration, or rather desecration, was spread in different forms all over the world. The galley, there it is right there, the galley priests. All right, so the Kedoshim, known from the Hebrew Bible, and also the Ugaritic texts, right, the Assyrian text of the late 2nd millennium BC, and the Caleb, priest of Astarte at Kition and elsewhere. Beyond India, modern ethnographic literature documents gender-variant shaman priests. Yeah, there you go. Gender-variant shaman priests throughout Southeast Asia, Borneo, and Sulawesi. All these roles share the traits of devotion to a goddess, gender transgression, and homosexuality, and actual or symbolic castration. Most at some point in their history were based in temples and therefore part of the religious economic administration, the mass media industrial complex of their respective city-states. These were high-ranking trannies, same as it ever was. The goddesses who stand at the head of these cults, Sibyl, Bahukara Mata, and Inanna Ishtar, and Mother Mary with the eunuch priests, also share important traits. All three are credited with the power to inspire divine madness, which can include the transformation of gender. Ishtar, the goddess of sexuality, is notoriously promiscuous, never marries, and indeed is herself a transvestite. To turn a man into a woman and a woman into a man are yours, Inanna. In all three cultural regions, the goddess-inspired priests were conceptualized as occupying a distinct gender category, as we have seen. Hydra routinely refer to themselves as neither men nor women. In a similar way, the flow of blood during the castration of Hydra is believed to empty them of both desire and gender. Because of this, they can serve as vehicles for the transmission of the sexual energy of the goddess. They become her phallus, as it were, erotic ascetics. So this is the entry on Ashtoreth. The chief goddess of the Phoenicians, as Baal, was the male. By the plural, different phases of the same deity. Ashtoreth, the female version, the female phase, and Baal was the male phase of one deity. The active and passive powers of nature, generative and receptive, suggested the male and female deities, Baal and Ashtoreth. And that's what the Freemasons talk about all the time. All right, here's another dictionary. Although a Baal was a male god and an Ashtoreth a female god, the two are often linked to represent the religion commonly known as Baalism. Ashtoreth of the Zidonians, Ishtar of the Akkadians, and Astarte of the Greeks, the Queen of Heaven, Mother Mary of the Catholics with their eunuch priests, kind of representing the eunuchs, right? The word eunuch can be used for someone who's chosen a life of celibacy. Catholicism is a goddess-worshipping cult. Of course, Diana was the name of Wonder Woman, the goddess of Ephesus, called Artemis by the Greeks, now under the male form, now under the female. The priests were eunuchs and were called megabazoi. The Ephesian cult of Artemis was by no means confined to Ephesus. The statement of Acts, whom all Asia and the Roman world worship, was no exaggeration. So this cult of transvestite priests worshiping the mother goddess was all over the world. Artemis worship was at length Christianized in the middle of the 5th century by the substitution of the mother god, Theotokos. This was the beginning of Mariolatry, all right? What do you think that means? Mariolatry, the idol worship of Mary, all right? Now, I always get these comments when I talk about Mary. Hey, Mary is a great woman, a human female, mother of Jesus Christ, but Mary is not a goddess. They changed the name again of Artemis to Mary, all right? Just like it changed from Inanna, Ishtar, Ashtoreth. Now it's Artemis, now it's Mary. First thing people do when they enter the Catholic Church is they bow down to Mary, right? When they enter a Catholic Mass, you gotta bow down to Mary. That's the first thing you do. I know a guy who's Catholic. He told the priest, he said, yeah, I'm praying to God, I'm praying to Jesus, you know, and I still have this problem. And the priest told him, oh, you gotta pray to Mary. It's Inanna Ishtar. It's the androgynous, self-generating deity. It's the mother goddess. And there's always a eunuch priest lurking around, molesting children, just like they did back in the day. The goddess was called the Queen of Heaven, and the worship was said to be paid to the host of heaven. Baal had priests and prophets consecrated to his service. Consecrated. All sorts of infamous and immodest actions were committed in the festivals of Baal and Astarte. Okay, now in Josephus' War of the Jews, 70 AD, when the Romans were attacking Jerusalem, Jews were actually fighting amongst themselves. They indulged themselves in feminine wantonness. They decked their hair and put on women's garments and were besmeared over with ointments that they might appear very comely. They had paints under their eyes and imitated not only the ornaments, but also the lusts of women. They rolled themselves up and down the cities. While their faces looked like the faces of women, they killed with their right hands. And when their gait was effeminate, they presently attacked men and became warriors.
Thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is abomination. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Doesn't matter if you're a boy, girl, or somewhere in between, we all are part of one big family. Queer kid stuff.
Yeah. Is everything in place?
The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us. You can see it when you look out your window or when you turn on your television. You can feel it when you go to work, when you go to church, when you pay your taxes. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
That you are a slave.
What's your problem?
Yo, I'm a paparazzi. I don't play no Yahtzee. I go pop, 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 pop. My camera's up your crotch.
If you want to be a drag queen and your parents don't let you, you need new parents. If you want to be a drag queen and your friends don't let you, you need new friends. Super pumped. I'm gonna walk the runway and I'm gonna Vogue.
Virgin Voguing, because he's been taking Voguing classes.
Okay.
With Gerard X. Reyes, who's fantastic. He's doing first time in drags at a ball.
For this cause, God gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature, and likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error which was meet. And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind, to do those things which are not convenient.
You see, I take these glasses off. She looks like a regular person, doesn't she, huh? Put them back on, formaldehyde face.
Old man river, that old man river.
You know, you look like your head fell on the cheese dip back in 1957.
The Matrix is a computer-generated dream world, built to keep us under control in order to change a human being into this.
Drag Queen Story Hour.
This one is called Worm Loves Worm.
Talking, singing, and reading.
We can both be grooms.
To an audience of preschoolers, toddlers, and their caregivers.
The hips on the drag queen go swish, 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 swish. I'm a girl.
Stop. Let me out. Let me out. I want to
look at them. They're everywhere.
Now hold on.
You ain't the first son of a bitch to wake up out of their dream.
The day my water broke, I was recording Jessica Rabbit.
No. I don't believe it. It's not possible.
You know what you need? You need a Brazilian plastic surgeon.
I've got one that can see.
Were you listening to me, Neo? Or were you looking at the woman in the red dress?
I was...
Look again.
I wrote unto you in an epistle not to company with fornicators, yet not altogether with the fornicators of this world, or with the covetous, or extortioners, or with idolaters, for then must ye needs go out of the world. But now I have written unto you not to keep company if any man that is called a brother be a fornicator, or covetous, or an idolater, or a railer, or a drunkard, or an extortioner. With such an one, know not to eat. For what have I to do to judge them also that are without? Do not ye judge them that are within? But them that are without, God judgeth. Therefore put away from among yourselves that wicked person.
The gains have been substantial, both for ourselves and for you, the human power elite. You have given us entree to the resources we need in our ongoing quest for multidimensional expansion.
You still don't get it, do you, boys? There ain't no countries anymore. No more good guys. They're running the whole show. They own everything.
He's a tall Caucasian male. Doesn't appear armed. Wearing sunglasses.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass. And I'm all out of bubblegum.
These are Jews who dressed up like women and attacked other Jews. In fact, they're kind of reenacting this goddess of fertility and warfare, right, by doing that. This is from one Enoch. Azazel taught men, you know, swords, knives, shield, breastplates, and basically warfare, right? And then bracelets, ornaments, the use of paint, beautifying of the eyebrows, right? Said they taught men so that the world became altered. Jubilees. And he told them of the judgment of the giants and the judgment of the transvestite pagan priests, how they had been judged on account of their wickedness. All right, now I'm going to talk about theater. Many societies prohibited women from performing on stage, so boys and men took the female roles. In the ancient Greek theater, men played females, as they did in English Renaissance theater, and continue to do so today. Japanese kabuki theater, onagata, that means female form. Chinese opera, specialized male actors who play female roles. Athens was the center. It was institutionalized as part of a festival called the Dionysia. Tragodia, two Greek words, tragos, or goat, ode, meaning song. Goat song, that's what tragedy means. So these fertility rituals became the basis for tragedy and comedy, right? Trannies in the theater. Same thing as trannies at the temple. Male actors playing female roles would wear a wooden structure on their chest to imitate the look of breasts, right? A little bit more high-tech nowadays. And another on their stomachs to make them appear softer and more ladylike. They're wearing a kind of moon bump back then. White body stockings under their costumes to make their skin appear fairer. Some of the Japanese gods have ambiguous gender, being neither male nor female. The belief spread that some people could change their gender depending on the lunar phase. The term half moon, hangetsu, was coined to describe such beings. Kabuki remains all male even today. Figure 1, sodomite in theater in the present era. Transvestite, pagan priest. There's the mask, right? There's the mask, tattoos, 33, and the male cult prostitute, the actor. A lot of these actors have transgendered children that are kind of openly transgender. I think this one does, actually. I think most of them do. And what does the name mean, by the way? Angelina Jolie, right? Remember, the J is a relatively new invention. Angel, right? Angel, holy, holy angel. And there we have implements of castration. Castration clamps found in the River Thames and now at the Museum of London. Bronze ritual Roman era castration clamps. And notice it looks just like a Freemason sign. This is castration, right? This peace sign, that's what it means. Castration, they're doing it near the eyes. You'll be enlightened and is doing this thing here as well, right? You know, there could be a number of meanings of this peace sign, and a lot of times people are just guessing at what they mean. But what does it mean for them? Why do they do it? I think it means this. And I think this means this. It's the same thing. It's a castration cult, transvestite cult, all for the goddess Inanna. They're castrated, transgendered, pagan priests. These people are in the transgendered elite that run the world. It's always been this way, really. Until the end, they will be destroyed, and we will inherit the earth, all right? This is the religion that's in direct opposition. They, in fact, they imitate everything, and they just do it totally opposite, right? These are the transvestite pagan priests and entertainers in the Babylonian and Greek and Jewish mystery schools, mystery religions. Combination of paganism and mysticism. All right, let me conclude. Morals and Dogma, Albert Pike, Freemason, 33rd degree. This union of the universe with itself, this mutual action of two sexes, he terms the great secrets of nature, the mysteries of the union of heaven with earth, imaged in the sacred mysteries of Attis and Bacchus, Dionysus. All the masters in alchemy who have written of the great work have employed symbolic and figurative expressions, being constrained to do so as well, to repel the profane, the uninitiated, from a work that would be dangerous for them, as to be well understood by adepts in revealing to them the whole world of analogies governed by the single and sovereign dogma of Hermes. So in their language, gold and silver are the king and queen, or the sun and moon, Ashtoreth and Baal, sulfur, the flying eagle, Mercury, the man-woman, the Adam Cadmon. That's the hexagram that's on the Great Seal of the United States and above the flying eagle. Winged and bearded, mounted on a cube, crowned with flames, matter or salt. The winged dragon, the metals and ebullition, lines of different colors, Inanna Ishtar. And finally, the entire work has for its symbols the pelican and the phoenix. All right, the phoenix is Inanna Ishtar. Inanna Ishtar descended to the other world and rose again. All right, that's what the phoenix is representing. Inanna descending to the underworld. How did Inanna return from the underworld? The Androgynes. Remember, the other god created a race of Androgynes so that Inanna Ishtar could return to Earth. So what I believe is that this is the origins of the modern-day transgender agenda. The nations are still under the control of these gods and goddesses with their transgendered, transvestite priests. Nothing's changed.
Okay, now more transgenders. Here's another one with Wendy Williams. You get your WW for your 33. You see the fake boobs, but you also see those hips. Okay, these are the hips, the legs of a man, clear as day. Just take a look at his face. Clearly a dude. I mean, give me a break. Fake boobs. A dude with a wig, what it all comes down to. Just take a look at his hideous face. A complete joke. Another one here. And this one they're not trying to pass off as a female. Another transgender named Laverne Cox. Again, if the media said this was a female, born a female, then 99% would buy it. And I'm sure a lot of men would lust for this man. Okay? Take a look here. The whole concept of Laverne Cox, of course, a play on names being the Statue of Liberty. I want to mention as well, it says the orange is the new black. Again, orange is the only color in numerology that is 33. Just take a look here. Another example of another transgender. And if the media said, once again, that this was born a female, the masses would fall for hook, line, and sinker. Now, take a look at this photo of when Laverne Cox, you know, of course, younger, and just compare. Okay? The media is nothing more than mind control. And again, getting back to the whole concept of the Statue of Liberty, this is a true depiction, as I've shown before, with the Statue of Liberty being nothing more than a transgender itself in the harbor of New York, going back to Greece. With Helios, just take a look here, making a comparison of the face of the Statue of Liberty with the statue of Apollo or Apollyon, a reference to Revelation 9:11 as the Antichrist and you can clearly see the resemblance. Basically identical. So it's pretty obvious what they're accomplishing, or what they're trying to accomplish, with the whole concept in plain sight of, again, the reality of the Statue of Liberty being nothing more than a transgender hidden in plain sight. And the whole idea of these transgenders going back in time with Dora Radjan and Stella Walsh. First, Dora Radjan here. I mean, give me a break. Obviously a male. Look at these photos. I mean, this one in particular. Look at those hands. Look at the body posture, the structure here. Clearly a dude. He's stiff as a board. Here's Stella Walsh on the right. Clearly a male as well. An absolute joke. And again, people are waiting for the media to tell them the truth. You'll be waiting a very, very long time, like I pointed out before, as well with George Clooney and his so-called wife, Amal, more like a male, clearly a dude. But again, people don't have their own minds. They're more like drones. Anytime you present them with this type of information, which is the truth, it's going to be rejected. Okay, because too much pride, too much ego, and then believing the media is going to tell them the truth. The media doesn't tell you the truth. They tell you nothing but lies. Clearly a male. But what it all comes down to when it comes to truth, all truth passes through three stages. First, it is ridiculed. Second, it is violently opposed. Third, it is accepted as being self-evident. So again, getting back to the very beginning of the video with Charlotte Flair. Like I stated before, the video I made in the past over a little bit over a year. It says a year here, but it's been a little bit over a year now. And the whole concept of, you know, the WWE trying to pass off this male as a female. And Ric Flair, give me a break. He will do anything for a buck. That includes selling out his son as a daughter. And clear as day, these photos 100% give it away. And again, the hair on the arm. And of course, the reason I showed all these other examples with the so-called Williams sisters, more like Williams brothers, and all the other examples is so people can connect the dots, connect the pieces in society where how is this allowed? Why is this happening? It's basically the sick psychopaths behind the scenes pulling the strings behind all of it. That's what it all comes down to. I spend so much time all the lies, keep the dream alive. It's easy to deceive, it's easy to tease, but hard to get relief. But it's gone from your eyes, I better realize. Rise out of this, such a human waste. Rise out of it.
Over the horizon. Over the horizon.